Hello students, a very good morning to you. How are you? I hope you are okay and continuing your syllabus. You have some complaints that you are unable to see the letters that I wrote in the on the blackboard and unable to hear the sound. So you can increase your resolution while watching the video and keep it at 480p, then you able to listen the sound properly as well as to visualize of the clear picture. Okay students, so in our previous class we have continued our chapter, that is chapter 14 of class 10th, which is physics, not biology, that is sources of energy. Clear? So in the last class we have studied about that sources of energy means conventional sources of energy, the energy that are used since a long time period. And today we will study about some alternate or non-conventional sources of energy. Okay students, so students, why there is a need for using the non-conventional sources of energy? As we know, the population of India is increasing, and due to increasing population their energy need is also increasing. To fulfill the energy need, we alone can't depend on fossil fuels, which is a non-renewable or exhaustible resource. That's why we need some resources or need some energy which we can use again and again, and they will not finish ever. That's why in this class we will study about solar energy, then energy from the sea, then your nuclear energy. Okay, in solar energy we will study about solar panels, solar cells and solar cooker. Then energy from the sea we will study about tidal energy, wave energy, ocean thermal energy, then geothermal energy. And in nuclear energy we will study about nuclear fission and fusion. Okay, so let's start our first topic of today, that is solar energy. Solar energy means when we obtain energy from the sunlight is called solar energy. As we know, the sun is, since we can't estimate the age present in the galaxy, and it gives us energy in many ways. We can take this energy for creating or producing electricity. So here I am telling you about the solar cookers. Solar cookers are a black furnished box on which glass piece is put which absorbs light. As we know, in greenhouse effect, what happens in greenhouse, the inner light or the heat is only trapped, but it can't be radiated. Exactly what happened, the solar cooker is based on that principle, means greenhouse effect principle. When we cover the box, a black colored box, by the help of a glass piece, it only absorbs or traps light, and inside it the food we keep is get cooked. You have also seen in the science exhibition that held in our school, one student showed the solar cooker and he prepared Maggie. So we can use for when we are going for campaignings or picnics, we can use solar cookers for making such items. This is another thing, that how we can produce solar energy. This is just the beginning, but the more solar energy can be obtained by using solar panels. Do you know what is solar panel? Solar panels are the combination of solar cells, means when many solar cells are combined, they form a solar panel. If you saw in our school also, the roof contain many solar panels, and they produce, means solar energy is converted into electric energy by joining these panels with the to the inverters. They just convert the solar energy into electric energy. We have not pay any electricity bill to government, that is directly we can produce. And this is also best source of energy. As we know, our India receives 5000 trillion kilowatt hour solar energy per year, and the average is 4 to 7 kilowatt hour per meter square. Means so much in our country India is so much lucky to receive the sunlight, and in a cloudless sky we can able to produce large amount of energy from sun. And if we produce, then may be from 0.5 to 1 volt. Sunlight can produce 0.7 watt of energy. So this is a good source of energy. But there are some demerits. When you have you will study about these energies, you will find that the sources of energy, non-conventional sources of energy we are studying, are not suitable because they have so many disadvantages. So first we will see what are the disadvantages and what are the advantages. The disadvantages of solar energy is, first, it needs complete exposure to sunlight. Clear? Second is, the solar cells or solar panel is made up of silicon. We know silicon is abundant in nature, but the silicon that is used for making solar panels are limited. Again, when the solar cells are connected to each other, they need silver, and silver is an expensive metal. That's why they can't be used by every people. But still, to minimize the use of fossil fuels in industries and in other areas also, solar panels are used to produce electricity. Also, in some areas, means this can be used in rural areas. Rural areas also, as it has low maintenance, in rural areas also, solar panels are used for producing electricity. As I have told you, its demerits is, it needs a high cost. Although it has low maintenance cost, but its preparation and its working needs no cost or no money. But when we make solar panel, that is so much expensive, and there is a chance of stolen. There is a case, the street lights of UP are fitted with solar panels. After some days, they were stolen. So this is not suitable. If we put it on our rooftop, then it may be stolen by any other. Silver is used. So students, solar energy, its different use or its beneficial uses are, we can say as, artificial satellites, traffic signals, its advantages. Solar light or solar energy is used in artificial satellites. You have seen that how satellites work in its on the orbit of the Earth or in the space. They are fitted with solar panels and receives energy from sun and converts into electric energy. So artificial satellites, street lights, traffic lights, calculators, clear, and kids toys are also fitted with solar cells. Means it has so many advantages, but as it is expensive, so it can't be afforded by everyone. Clear, students? Although it is a non-conventional source and it is renewable and we can get it in enough amount, but still we can't be considered as a good source of energy. Clear? Next moves to energy from the sea. We know that energy is also produced from sea in the form of wave energy, tidal energy, etc., etc. So how the energy is produced from the sea? If you ever been to the sea coast or you are living in sea coast, you can see electricity produced in large amounts, and a danger sign is put on the shore of the sea that don't go too much distance, that high electricity is produced here. So how the electricity is produced here? Let's see. First, tidal energy. We know that tides are produced continuously due to the wind. Means the tides high tide and low tide. This is because the gravitational pull of the moon on the spinning of the earth. Means when the earth pulls, the gravitational pull by the moon, it creates the tides, and the tides are formed. There some dams are made, and the dam have small openings in which turbines are fitted. As we know, turbine is needed to produce electricity. So when the tides strikes on the turbines start rotating and produces electricity. Then the electricity is again transferred to the generators. Clear. Next is your wave energy. What is wave energy? Kinetic energy possessed by huge waves. Huge waves due to strong wind blowing means like your wave energy, tidal energy. Sorry, like your tidal energy, wave energy is also works. How it works? It works on kinetic energy. As we know, in due to kinetic energy, when kinetic energy will flow, if the wind speed is maximum, then the tide produced or wave produced is maximum. So these waves, when strikes, again I have told you that there are some dams are made in regular intervals where turbines are fitted. When the waves strikes like tides, when the waves strikes to the turbines, they rotate and produce electricity and they are stored in the generator and transported to various purposes. But they are also, we can't consider as good source of energy because sea is not found all around the country. The areas where seas are not present, then how electricity from the sea is possible? And energy production is so much less and expensive also. You think how energy will be produced from sea by using so much money. Here the best source of energy we can say as fossil fuel, but as we know it is it will be very soon completely exhausted. That's why we need to create some alternate source of energy. That's why we are trying to produce energy from tide and from wave. Means the areas where tide and waves, means where seas are available, these areas can be fulfilled by the energy from seas. Next is your ocean thermal energy. What is ocean thermal energy? Here our energy from sea. Here ocean. Ocean means the large seas. When we watch carefully or when we study about ocean thermal energy, then we can see there is a temperature difference between the sea. Means if we consider up to 2 km depth of the ocean, then the temperature difference causes the rise in temperature. That increasing temperature can be used. Means the temperature difference inside the ocean is not constant. Clear? So the energy, means the energy that is produced in the ocean is the wave or the energy or the heat is produced is not constant. Due to the difference, means temperature difference, here some volatile substances like ammonia is used. And when ammonia is put in it, then it converts it into vapor. And that vapor or steam, you know, is used to rotate the turbine. And when the turbine is rotated, then electricity is produced. And that is supplied to the nearby parts. Okay, but again all the parts of the ocean will not have the temperature difference, and the temperature difference is 20 degrees Celsius, which is sufficient to melt the volatile substance like ammonia, which we can say 20 degrees Celsius or 293 Kelvin. Next is your geothermal energy. Thermal means heat. Geo means earth. Sometimes the geothermal energy can be produced from the gravity. How? Well, remember, geological changes and molten rocks. As we know, inside the earth, there are some geological changes occurs. Your earthquakes, then tsunamis, then lava and molten rocks. Due to these geological changes, the earth's crust get hit. And sometimes it brushed. And due to its brusting, water arises up, and the water rises up have a high temperature, and the steam produced from that water can be used to rotate a turbine and to produce electricity. But this is also not found in all areas, so it also limited it. We can also produce a limited energy from it, and this is very rare in India. But this geothermal energy is working or functional in New Zealand and USA, United States of America. Some areas or some part of these countries have able to produce geothermal energy as they have availability of those thermal energy. Next is your nuclear energy. What is nuclear energy? When we produce energy from source of nucleus, nucleus means atoms, molecules, etc. But it has a high energy producing affinity, means it can produce high energy, but still it has also some demerits. So how energy is produced in it and what are its demerits? Nuclear energy is produced by two ways. One is your nuclear fission and another is your nuclear fusion. In fission, a heavy nucleus is split into lighter nucleus, and during its fission, it produces high amount of energy. We can say that according to the great scientist Einstein, who produced the formula or who derived the formula, E is equal to mc square. So energy can be produced in a great amount or in a huge amount by using this formula. So nuclear fission is used in some developed country like USA, China and any other. Even their energy input is up to 30% energy input is completed through nuclear energy. So nuclear energy is the best source of energy. Again, for the employment or the people used in this energy production are so much educated, and they are belong from IT sectors, and they have a much more knowledge of nuclear energy. Otherwise, nuclear accidents may occur. Means nuclear accidents means the accident that caused to using the atomic powers. Next is your nuclear fusion. Nuclear fusion means when two lighter nuclei are joined to form a heavier nuclei. This is based on how the sun gives us energy. The sun's energy never decreases. Every time its energy is get increased. How? In sun, continuously hydrogen is get converted into helium, and helium is a good source of energy, means it produces high amount of heat. So here hydrogen bomb is also based on nuclear fusion. Nuclear fusion. Nuclear fusion means when lighter nuclei are joined. So students, here H2 plus H2 gives rise to 3He, means hydrogen plus hydrogen gives rise to helium plus nucleus. In its nucleus, hydrogen get converted into helium, due to which high amount of energy is produced. And I have told you that hydrogen bomb is based on thermonuclear reaction, means the hydrogen bomb is covered by either deuterium, which is the isotope of hydrogen, or lithium. And when it is bombarded, then continuously the hydrogen, the isotopes of hydrogen get converted into helium, and the energy increases. So it has a great output, but it is so much risk for using it without proper knowledge. That's why we can't consider it a good source of energy. And the energy produced is 10 to the power 7 times much more than the initial energy. As I have told you, in the developed country, nuclear energy is used for supplying electricity to different areas, but still they have a great risk of disposal of this nuclear waste. If the nuclear waste are not properly disposed, then they may cause damage to the earth or to the locality. That's why we can't consider as nuclear energy is also a good source of energy. Overall, from the above topics, we can conclude that there are so many alternatives or alternate sources of energy or non-conventional sources of energy. But the source of energy that we maximum depend on is fossil fuels. And fossil fuel is non-renewable and exhaustible, means which will completely finish in near future due to our exercise use. If we judiciously use it in a minimum manner, and we can use it than less than our need, then we can able to save it for our next generation. Although they are also need to increase some sources of energy for our need, but still we can't say that non-conventional sources of energy are better than conventional source of energy like coal and petroleum, means fossil fuels. So from this chapter we can conclude that the conventional sources of energy are best sources of energy. Our next topic is environmental consequences. What is the meaning of environmental consequences? Consequences means results, means when we are using some sources of energy, then it have some consequences. As we use fossil fuels, then it produces a large amount of smokes which pollutes the environment. That's why due to pollution of the environment, many plants and animals are die. Some also die before their age completed, and it also pollutes the soil, pollutes water, etc., etc. So we should use the resources or sources of energy in a manageable way. So they are the consequences of energy. Next topic is your how long will an energy source last? Means if we use the sources of energy like this, then how much we can use it? Students, remember, we have to decrease our energy need. If we do not decrease our energy need, then one day will come, we have no source of energy. We will sitting only by burning a candle, no fan, no AC, because there may be no energy left, no fossil fuel left. So for the avoiding the situation that will come in future, we should have to aware and save our energy. Okay, students? Thank you.